ULA just swapped Sierra Space's Dream Chaser launch. Something even bigger is coming. Yes, you heard it right. Next new Shepard flight. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello, everyone. I'm back with another update. Yes, today we have two episodes. This one, however, comes with some bittersweet news. Many of you, especially the Dream Chaser fans in our community, have been asking me about what's happening with Sierra Space's Dream Chaser and why I haven't covered it lately. So here's the update you've been waiting for. The Dream Chaser spaceplane from Sierra Space has experienced yet another delay in its long-awaited debut in space. Initially scheduled for a summer 2024 launch aboard United Launch Alliance's ULA new Vulcan Centaur rocket, the mission has been postponed. This decision aligns with ULA's commitment to prioritize two critical national security missions mandated by the US Space Force that must be completed by the end of 2024. This delay further elongates the already extensive timeline for Dream Chaser, a spacecraft that has navigated numerous hurdles since its inception. With the Dream Chaser's launch deferred, ULA will now proceed with its second-ever launch of the Vulcan Centaur, termed CERT-2, no earlier than September 2024. CERT-2 is a crucial military certification flight that will carry an inert payload along with various experiments and demonstrations. ULA CEO Tory Bruno announced this revised plan on June 26, 2024, emphasizing the necessity of these launches for national security. The third launch, another preparation mission for the US Space Force, is slated for the end of 2024. So, what is CERT-2 mission? Well, the CERT-2 mission aims to measure the propellant boil-off from the Centaur upper stage and send undisclosed experiments to orbit to extend the duration of the upper stage. The successful completion of this mission is pivotal for ULA, as it will solidify the Vulcan Centaur's reliability for subsequent national security missions. Now, is Sierra Space pissed off by the new decision? Not at all. They remain optimistic despite the delay, asserting that Dream Chaser could still be ready for launch by the end of 2024. According to a company representative, significant progress has been made, and the spaceplane remains on track for a timely flight. The representative acknowledged the critical nature of ULA's CERT-2 mission and expressed the company's commitment to working closely with ULA to identify the next available launch opportunity for Dream Chaser. The Dream Chaser spaceplane, with its design rooted in the legacy of NASA's space shuttle and Soviet-era concepts, has endured a complex development journey. Initially, an early contender in NASA's Commercial Crew program, Dream Chaser was eventually not selected in favor of SpaceX's Crew Dragon and Boeing's Starliner in 2014. This decision prompted Sierra Nevada Corporation, SNC, the previous parent company of Sierra Space, to file a protest with the U.S. Government Accountability Office. The protest was overturned, but it did not mark the end of Dream Chaser's aspirations. In 2016, Dream Chaser secured a significant role under NASA's Commercial Resupply Services 2, CRS-2 contract, which mandated at least 6 resupply missions to the International Space Station, ISS. Alongside SpaceX's Dragon and Northrop Grumman's Cygnus, Dream Chaser was set to contribute to NASA's logistical operations in low Earth orbit. Since then, Sierra Space has been diligently working on Dream Chaser's development, including extensive ground testing and autonomous glide flights. Earlier this year, engineers conducted vibration and pressure testing at NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Ohio. ULA's first Vulcan launch successfully delivered the private astrobotic technology Peregrine moon lander to space, despite an unrelated spacecraft anomaly that prevented the lander from reaching its destination. This inaugural launch demonstrated Vulcan's potential, giving ULA and the US Space Force the confidence to accelerate their subsequent missions. ULA's Bruno described the first Vulcan flight as a perfect flight and a bullseye, smooth as silk, noting that the performance instilled confidence in moving forward with the planned national security missions. ULA is investing a high tens of millions in these two national security preparations launches in 2024, anticipating that this investment will lead to new contracts. ULA's focus on these launches underscores the strategic importance of the Vulcan Centaur in US national security infrastructure. The success of these missions is expected to position ULA for an intensive 2025, with plans to execute up to 20 launches, contingent upon satellite readiness. This ambitious schedule includes launches using both the Atlas V and Vulcan Centaur rockets, reflecting ULA's capacity to support a wide range of missions. Despite the setbacks, Dream Chaser remains a critical component of Sierra Space's vision for the future of space transportation. The spaceplane's design offers a versatile platform capable of performing a variety of missions, from ISS resupply to potential crewed missions and commercial applications. Dream Chaser's ability to land on conventional runways and its reusability make it an attractive option for rapid turnaround and flexibility in space operations. Sierra Space's continued progress on Dream Chaser, including advancements in autonomous flight capabilities and structural testing, indicates a resilient commitment to overcoming the technical and logistical challenges associated with spaceplane development. The eventual success of Dream Chaser will not only enhance Sierra Space's portfolio, but also contribute to the broader commercial space industry by providing an additional means of transporting cargo and possibly crew to and from low Earth orbit. You know, the collaboration between ULA and Sierra Space highlights the intricate dynamics of modern space missions, where coordination between different entities is essential for mission success. ULA's role as the launch provider and Sierra Space's development of Dream Chaser exemplify the interdependent nature of space missions, where launch schedules, technical readiness, and strategic priorities must be precisely aligned. ULA's decision to prioritize national security missions reflects a broader trend in the space industry, where government and commercial interests often intersect. For Dream Chaser, the upcoming months will be crucial in determining the spaceplane's path forward. Sierra Space's ability to adhere to the revised timeline and successfully integrate Dream Chaser into ULA's launch manifest will be pivotal in demonstrating the viability of spaceplane technology for a variety of missions. As a conclusion, the delay in Dream Chaser's launch, while disappointing, is a reflection of the complex and dynamic nature of space missions. I know it's really unexpected, but at the same time, it's promising to hear that it will launch within the end of 2024. A historic milestone is on the horizon for Nigeria, as the country is poised to send its first citizen to space courtesy of Jeff Bezos's aerospace company Blue Origin. This groundbreaking opportunity is made possible through a partnership between Blue Origin and the Space Exploration and Research Agency, CERA, a US-based for-profit company. CERA has reserved one of the six seats on the upcoming New Shepard suborbital vehicle flight for a Nigerian astronaut, as reported by Semaphore. This development is a significant step towards bridging the gap in space exploration for nations that have historically lacked access to space. CERA's initiative aims to provide opportunities for citizens of such countries to experience space travel. The partnership between Blue Origin and CERA was formalized in April, paving the way for collaborative efforts in space tourism. The Nigerian government has shown its support for this initiative by signing a memorandum of understanding with CERA. Matthew Adepaju, Director General of the National Space Research and Development Agency, NASARDA, expressed his enthusiasm for this development, highlighting Nigeria's strides in space exploration. Not many nations in Africa dreamt of having a space program, but today, NASARDA is the only space agency in Africa whose activities cover the entire space, Adepaju remarked. The selection process for the Nigerian astronaut will be transparent and independent, allowing citizens to nominate and vote for their preferred candidate. According to CERA co-founder Joshua Skirla, the application process will be open to all Nigerians above 18 years of age, with no additional qualifications required. This approach ensures that the opportunity is accessible to a wide range of individuals, fostering a sense of national ownership and excitement. Nigeria's space sector, though modest, has achieved notable milestones, including the launch of satellites built by other nations. The National Space Research and Development Agency, NASARDA, has outlined its objectives, which include developing indigenous satellite technology capabilities, leveraging space technology for sustainable development, and venturing into human spaceflight. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.